Hello, assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna talk about CBC, complete blood count, and how to interpret its result, then how to diagnose patient cases. I'll make the interpretation of CBC report easier. So if this is your first time to watch me, press subscribe, like, share, and comment with any question related to medical lab sciences. So let's begin. First of all, CBC or complete blood count is a blood test used to evaluate person's overall health and detect wide range of disorders including anemia, infections and leukemia. CBC test includes many components and I will put definitions and functions for each one at the last of this video and in description. So let's talk about how practically you can diagnose a patient case using CBC report. Firstly, when you find all these three, white BCs, RBCs, and platelet counts are high, it indicates polycythemia rubra vera. But if you find only RBCs count is high while the others normal, it's polycythemia. Second case, when you find all these three, white BCs, RBCs, and platelet counts are low, it's pancytopenia. To determine specifically which type, we measure reticulocyte count. If retic count is high, it's hypersplenism. And if it was low, it's aplastic anemia. Don't worry, I will put definitions and functions of all these terms at the last of this video and in the description. Third case, if you find RBC's count is low, it indicates there is anemia. To determine which type of anemia, you should check the level of hemoglobin, hematocrit, and RBC's indices, which are MCV, MCH, and MCHC. When MCV and MCHC are low, it is called microcytic hypochromic anemia, and it includes several types of anemia, as iron deficiency anemia, thalassemia, sideroblastic, and anemia of chronic disease. To differentiate between them, we must make an iron profile test, iron, TIBC, and ferritin. If iron and ferritin were low, while the TIBC is high, it's iron deficiency anemia. And if iron and TIBC were low, while the ferritin is high, it's anemia of chronic disease. If iron, TIBC, and ferritin were normal, it indicates thalassemia, and we recommend doing hemoglobin electrophoresis. Okay, then let's go. If MCV is high, it's called macrocytic anemia, which may be one of two. Megaloblastic anemia, if there is a deficiency in vitamin B12 or folic acid. In this case, you can find hypersegmented neutrophils. Non-megaloblastic anemia, if there are some diseases as liver disease or effects by some drugs and alcohol. In this case, you won't find hypersegmented neutrophils. Finally, if MCV, MCH, and MCHC were normal, it's called normocytic normochromic, and it includes hemolytic or acute bleeding. Now, what about white BCs count? If it was high while RBCs and platelet counts were low, it's called leukemia. And to determine if it's acute or chronic, we should check the level of blast cells. If blast cells were more than 20%, it's acute. If blast cells less than 20%, it's chronic. When white BCs count is high while RBCs and platelet counts were normal, here we think about infection. If neutrophil count is high, it's a bacterial infection. If lymphocyte count is high, it's viral infection, except in the case of coronavirus, which causes COVID-19. Here, the count will be low. Monocyte count is being high in the case of glandular fever. Eosinophil count will be high in parasitic or allergic cases. Finally, basophils rises in immunological diseases. Okay, now we move to platelet count. If you find platelet count was low, it's called thrombocytopenia. Then it's better to do bleeding time, PT and PTT tests. When the count is normal, focus, here I said the count, not the morphology. And the patient still suffering from bleeding, the cause may be deficient in platelets function as von Willebrand disease, or problem in coagulation factors as hemophilia A and B, or a vascular problem. Okay, thus CBC report as simple as that. And I hope you enjoyed this video and understood clearly and simply how to interpret the CBC report. So in the end, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and if you have any question, ask me in the comments. See you in the next videos and bye.